Hi, this is Chris Brown, Technical Services Supervisor at Danfoss. In today's video, we'll cover how to build a calculation that's importing a sensor from a case controller in our Danfoss System Manager. So when we look at a calculation where we want to bring in values from a case controller, there's a lot of different reasons we may want to do that. What we're bringing in could be temperature sensors, it could be the status of a relay on the case controller. So keep that in mind as we go through this video here, that I'll show an example where we're looking at defrost relays, but this could easily be temperature values from the case controllers or any other value really that you feel the need to bring in for whatever logic you're trying to achieve. So in this video, I have two case controllers configured, 1 and 2. So the first step in the process here is to make sure we're bringing in the data points or importing the data points that we want to use in the logic. So I will go to configuration, control, refrigeration, and then circuits. And we're under the assumption that the case controllers are already configured in the system manager. So from here, we can go to the setup tab. And then again, now I have two import options, SI and OI. If I want to import temperature sensors, I'll obviously use the SI option. You can see up to 16 sensor points can be imported from the case controller or from each case controller. Just to show you as an example, if I wanted to import the main sensor value from the case controller here, I can choose that value from the list. And then you also have to make sure the type is configured properly. So if I tried to import a pressure transducer, I would need to make sure I'm changing the type to pressure afterwards, or else it would show up with the wrong units later on in the calculation. For this example, though, where we're looking at defrost relay status, I'll go to import OI. And for the first case controller, again, I'll select import number 1. Our U values are always our statuses in the case controller. So here I'll scroll down to U60 for our defrost relay. And I'll import that. Type can be left at normal. If I do the same for a second case controller here, I can hit the drop-down list and go to my second circuit or my second case controller. I'm still under import OI. I will now look for that same relay value, U60, and I'll enable that as well. Now that we have the points enabled that we want to use in the calculation, now we can return to the control tab and start to build the logic itself. So from control, miscellaneous, and then calculations. Here we can enable a new calc. We will double click on that calculation to get into the setup of it. Our units here, we would be looking to turn something on or off with this logic. So we want to leave units as OI. Style, we'll leave it generic. There's not necessarily a predefined template that would use any of the specific styles that are options here. Description, you would name based on however you feel you're using this calculation to control a point in the system manager. We'll just call this defrost calculation for this exercise. And then we get into our data point types. Now, data point type, keep in mind that even though we're looking at a physical relay on the case controller, that the system manager is importing it as just a digital input. So we want to make sure our data point type is set to OI and not RO. Once I've done that, you can now see that the defrost relays that I imported from the case controllers are listed here as options for an input. The formatting of the points here, so 1:1 would mean this is my first case controller, which has an address of 1, and it was the first data point that I imported, or the first OI specific data point that I imported from that case controller. Similarly, down here below that, case controller address 2, and then the first OI data point I had imported from that one. We will choose OI1. We need to add a line or a data point in for the second case controller. So I'll make sure I double click on data point type here. Again, select OI. And for the input of this one, I'll say case controller number 2, first data point. So we have the two data points. Now it's a matter of what do we want to do with the calculation. If we want to look at a logic where we're turning some relay, maybe it's a master hot gas valve or something along those lines. If we want to turn the calculation on anytime either one of these relays is active, we want to go down here to our results section. And if I just double click on the first line, this will take me into my secondary results setup screen. I can get rid of this blank line that really has no data associated with it. The top line for type, I want to change that from off to on. The type is what the calculation will do given the conditions I'm about to configure under it. And here I want to say if either one of those two relays from the case controller is on, I want to turn my calculation on. So for each data point and operator, I'll configure OI1, OI2, which again is our two imported relays. For the operator, I'll use the OR option so that either one of these being true, we'll bring the calculation on. And then down here under our remaining condition of true, and this is like an else statement more or less, so that if the top option is not true, if we don't have OI1 or OI2 on, then we want to default to whatever this option is. And that would mean we want to turn the calculation off. So this would be the configuration that would allow us to turn the calculation on anytime either of our defrost relays are on, and then turn the calculation off if neither of the two are on. We'll click on the calculations option there to return to the full setup of the calculation so you can see the initial setup and then the results all configured on the same screen. And then from here, just keep in mind that if you want to use this calculation for, say, a miscellaneous relay, that you would then have to go to that miscellaneous relay section and assign the calculation number as your control input for that relay so that it would apply to the logic of that relay. Thanks for watching our video. For more technical documentation and videos on our system managers, please visit danfoss.com/supermarket support.